With all of the new changes in the 2018 Jeep Wrangler, will we still be haunted with death wobble? Let's find out. Welcome back. My name is Brandon here with another view, and today we're going to be taking a look at the all-new 2018 Jeep Wrangler steering and front suspension system. We're going to see if Jeep has made any changes to help prevent death wobble for the future Jeep Wrangler owner. Now, if you haven't already subscribed, go ahead and do that down below. Make sure you click that bell icon so you don't miss any new Jeep content. So today we're going to go over what death wobble is, what changes did they make on the JL body versus the JK, will the changes that they made be effective, and what to do if you ever experience death wobble. Okay, so if you've been around Jeep long enough, I'm sure you've heard the term death wobble. And if you've ever experienced it, you know why they call it that. Now, personally, I have experienced it before, and I hope none of you out there watching ever have to. But if you have, leave me a comment below. Let me know how you felt behind the steering wheel. Okay, so for those of you who this is your first Jeep Wrangler purchase, or you have no idea what we're talking about when we say death wobble, this next video is going to show you exactly what it is. My friends out on the west coast of California, Rare Parts Incorporated, have been awesome enough to be able to capture this extreme moment on tape. Now, if you want to see their full video, make sure you click this link up in the top right corner. I also have links to their channels and both their websites down in the description area. All right, so first off, you can see there's something here in the road. They've laid a 2x4, 4x4, something out here to where when they hit it, it actually jars the steering and suspension system. It could be a pothole. It could be, you know, who knows what it could be. Just use your imagination. You hit something in the road going 40-some miles an hour, and this is what starts to happen. Guys, look how severe this is. This is crazy. There's a couple things I noticed in this video, and I'll get to those here in a minute, so make sure you keep watching. All right. Next, let's take a look at the steering suspension components on the new JL body to see if Jeep made any new changes. So first off, I see that the steering knuckle is made of aluminum instead of steel like the old JK body is. It also looks like the upper ball joint mount, which is part of the axle housing, is thinner. So definitely so far they're focused on weight reduction. Next, let's take a look at the drag link. Doesn't really look like too much change here besides that aluminum knuckle where it mounts. All right, moving down to the right side tie rod end. Man, this thing looks a lot stronger here. They're using this I-beam style type of tie rod end that gives it a lot more strength. And also they have this looking, this bracket here that that houses the steering stabilizer shock mount. And you can see where the two bolts go through the tie rod end to give it even more strength than it already has. Not much going on here in the lower ball joint area. As you can see, the knuckle is aluminum that we've already talked about. The axle housing here is a little bit thicker than the previous version on the JK. All right, moving over here to the driver's side, you can see that the left side tie rod is still using that same type of I-beam style of tie rod end that's much stronger than the previous version, I think. All right, let's go back and take a look at Rare Parts Incorporated's JK Jeep. And you can see here that this gentleman here has upgraded most of his steering components. He's got a drag link that's huge. He's got the tie rod end down at the bottom this big. He's got piggyback shocks, you name it. After all the upgrades, he's still got death wobble. I'll explain why in just a minute, so make sure you keep watching. There's several more changes that Jeep has made to the JL. So one being the aluminum steering box. As you can see here, it's not made out of steel anymore to reduce more weight. Also, the bolts that go through that steering gear are not threaded into the box. They're actually bolt throughs with the nuts on the end of them. And the pitman arm and nut actually look a little bit bigger also. So let's swing up and take a look at the track bar, which is one of the main components in this death wobble situation that we're looking at here. The track bar is different, okay? It's made a little different. What's so important about a track bar is not actually the size of it. It's actually the quality of the bushing. So if Jeep has not changed the quality of the bushings on the track bars, then we're still gonna be dealing with the same situations that we have in the past. Okay, so here's one of the biggest changes on the JL versus the JK, the power steering pump. We no longer have a belt-driven power steering pump. It is now electric. You may or may not like the electric power steering pump, but unfortunately, everything's going electric these days. Even Jeep has talked about making a plug-in hybrid Wrangler. If you want to know more about that, click this link right above. It'll take you right to it. All right, let's move down and talk about the steering stabilizer shock. As you can see, Jeep has moved over more closer to the passenger side and has got the base of it mounted to the right side tie rod end, and then the other side mounted to the axle. Now, I'm not really sure if this is going to help out with death wobble or not, because this is not really the root cause of death wobble, which a lot of people think that it is, but it gets a real bad rap. So, you know, you can put, you know, a bigger one of these things on, you can put a double shock on, it's just not going to fix it. It's just a band-aid. It may take care of it for a time being, but I will explain here in a few minutes of what it will take to get rid of death wobble, and this is part of it, but it's not the main cause, okay? Moving back to the lower control arms here, as you can see, there's not much real change to there. Hopefully that Jeep increased the quality of the bushings, because this sometimes can also be a big part of the death wobble. All right, up to the upper control arms. Wow, you can see kind of a difference here, not really in the control arm itself, but the protection of the bearing. They've got lots of heat shields over here to your left, as you can see on the new JL body, to protect the bushing from heat, and that's actually a lot of what can cause some of the wear and tear on these bushings. So the big question is, of all the changes that Jeep made on the new JL Wrangler, will it prevent death wobble? Well, my personal opinion is no. And I'll give you that reason. The reason behind it is that the 2018 Jeep Wrangler has a solid front axle. You see, this has been one of Jeep's icons for years, but it actually comes with a price. So solid axles with worn steering and suspension components over time will lead to death wobble. Let's take, for example, the Jeep in the Rare Parts Incorporated video. He has lots of upgrades to the steering and suspension system, but the thing you couldn't see was that the gearbox was worn out, the control arm bushings were worn out, and since he had it lifted, the alignment was incorrect and the caster was off. So there's a couple of things that you need to know about death wobble. The first one is, you will never, ever, ever see it on a brand new Jeep Wrangler off the showroom floor. But you will see it always on a Jeep that has some age and some wear and tear on it. And why is that? Let me explain. So you purchased the vehicle brand new, okay? You drive it, you've got 10, you've got 20,000 miles on it, all is well. You hit around 40,000 miles and you start to get a slight vibration, okay? So what happens is maybe you have a wheel that's out of balance, okay? And that slight vibration will start to wear other components such as the tie rod ends, the upper control arm bushings, the track bar bushings. All these things will wear over time, okay? And maybe one or each of those components have just a small amount of wear on them, and yet not big enough to replace, but yet when you add them all together, they create one big problem, and it's the death wobble. That's what it is. So let's talk about how you would go about fixing a Jeep with death wobble. Where do you even start with something like this? We've seen in the previous video, the guy had all these things done to it, but yet he still had it. So what you do is, unfortunately, a lot of people may disagree with me, and I'm okay with that. But I'm going to say, replace all of your steering and suspension components. And the reason I say that is because if you've got 40 and 50,000 miles on your Jeep, okay, every one of those steering and suspension components has some wear or tear, okay? If you just replace that one piece that might have some wear and tear, it's not going to be no time before it's worn out again, because you've got other components that are worn. They all work together. The steering components all work together. And if you've got one thing that's bad or starting to go bad, it accelerates the wear on the other components. So I'm going to say, for the fix, replace the ball joints, replace the tie rod ends, replace the front, the upper and lower control arm bushings. Make sure the steering box is new. Make sure your alignment is dead on the money. If you got new tires, make sure they're balanced right. The steering stabilizer shock. Guys, you can't just replace one of these items that is worn out and fix death wobble. It might temporarily fix it, but it's not going to fix it for good. That brand new vehicle that goes off the showroom floor does not have any wear and tear on any of the steering and suspension components, and it doesn't do it. I know it might sound expensive, but It's the fix for it, okay? The fix for it is to replace all the steering and suspension components, and it's fixed for good. If you've got your Jeep lifted, okay, make sure you check with the manufacturer of the lift what the alignment specs are supposed to be, and make sure you get somebody good that does the alignment. You don't need to be having a brand new lift on this thing, your Jeep looking sweet, going on a hot date, and you got the whole front end shaking, dude. How embarrassing is that? Okay, so for the new Wrangler, they did make a lot of good changes, and it may help some a little bit, but I really don't think it's going to help a lot. Well, I think we'll still see it down the road. You know, once we get some age on this thing, we'll find out if I'm right or wrong. So I really appreciate you guys watching, and I hope you're safe out there. I hope no one ever has to deal with death wobble. So thank you again, and have a great day.